How are you doing, Victor? Welcome to Your Entertainment Ticket. Glad to see you.
Good to see you, Al.
Well, you're an artist. What is an artist?
An artist is anybody who finds a way of expressing themselves, either through music, through painting, through any form of self-expression.
Because I remember I used to teach humanities when I was a college professor, and many of the books stated that an artist is someone who does something, then reveal it to other people. So that way they are sharing it with someone that makes it art. Do you like that definition? I mean, I like your definition.
I think your definition is right to the extent that if we're on an island and we create something that is a masterpiece, if nobody is around there to share the experience, then is it art? It's like a tree falling in the woods. But essentially, I believe that art is just a form of human self-expression.
Great. Yeah, that's what I believe also. Now, a few of your paintings that I have observed myself, they have many of the subject matters are the public and human beings, you know, what's happening in our society, our American society. So do you get a lot of your, let's say, your ideas about from the American society?
Yeah, because I live here. I was born and raised in the United States, and I feel I'm a patriot. I do love the concept of democracy. I realize, however, that we're living in a new democracy. A lot of my inspiration is from what I see around me.
Now, what about things that you painted that was in the news somewhere, you know, some of my audience might know about, or some things that you decided to paint about? Give me some subject matter that you painted.
All right, this piece is called, it's got two names actually, The Backpacker, and also What I Heard the Day Pope John Paul II Died. What I did was right here on this side, I actually wrote down things that I overheard on the day that Pope John Paul II died, either at cafes or at meetings or what have you. So those are actual sayings of things that I heard on that day. And the inspiration for this piece was that I used to be in politics. And when I was in politics, I was an elected official who came upon some things that were improper. And I noticed that the higher up the chain of command that I went, the less stuff got done. I was basically told, listen, take a number. There's so much corruption going on. You know, get on the back of the line. So my frustration, and again, just I didn't have a therapist at the time, so the only way to deal with this was basically by painting it. So I ended up painting this painting, which has a lot of different symbolism in it. There's references to swastikas, because one of the things that I was fighting for was to get swastikas that were emblazoned on the elevators at this high-rise building of over 1,500 residents that I was presiding over removed. But the powers that be told me that apparently they couldn't do it. Why they couldn't do it, I couldn't understand. I volunteered my own money to get that stuff taken off, but they couldn't do it. What they said was that they couldn't print the letter that I wrote because it had the word swastika in it. And then when I told them I would go public with it, they said that if I spoke, I would be held liable. So that's where the genesis came for me realizing that I could actually paint what I saw rather than writing it to avoid the threat of libel and slander. Because this is all interpretive. This is artwork that if you want to interpret it any way you want, you go for it. And if you have a guilty conscience about it, well, that's on you. But there are a lot of facts in here, and there are a lot of history in here. You've got references to the Vietnam War. You've got references to the Heil Hitler over there. You've got the word swasti, because originally swastika was not something negative. It was actually something of a religious connotation. And it's also got the thing from Hurricane Katrina, the blood that was spilled after the levees broke, which had nothing to do with nature. That had to do with improper government ability to take care of their people. So the backpacker represents everybody. That's an ethereal figure. It could be a man or a woman who's just going through life and experiencing different things in life. And this piece, basically, again, paying homage to one of my favorite artists, Salvador Dali, is just to be interpreted by the people. Okay, this piece is called The Three Soldiers. It represents the U.S. soldier when we invaded Iraq as the Great White Hope. The Taliban, who's got his arm around the Iraqi soldier right here. The top was supposed to be the only piece that was showed during an exhibit that I did called the Hurricane Wilma exhibit. The reason why was because the top was supposed to be something symbolizing pro-war, but that's not what this piece was supposed to signify, so I would not give in to the censorship, and I wanted the whole piece to be shown because the bottom piece shows the huddled masses yearning to be free, and those masses include the people in Darfur who are suffering, the plight of the people from Hurricane Katrina, and the plight of everyone around the world who basically needs the help of the United States. And if the United States really was championing what we claim to be championing, then we would be doing the right thing, not just for the people in Iraq, but for the people all over the place. So that's what that piece signifies. This piece used to be called The Man in the Middle. But after seeing what was happening in the United States with the housing crisis and with the financial, the global financial crisis, I realized that really we are all united, true, but we're esclavos unidos, which in Spanish means united slaves. In Spanish, Estados Unidos means the United States, but esclavos unidos means united slaves. And so that's what this piece was. It was a warning to people to let them know, you know, should I invest in the United States? Again, this was all before the market crashed. Originally, I'd put down, do not invest in the United States, because I was trying to warn people. However, friends of mine from the media came in and they said, listen, if you do that, you're going to ostracize yourself from everybody because that's going to make you seem unpatriotic. And I agreed with them because I am not unpatriotic. My thing was just, again, a warning. Like these paintings, they tell a story and sometimes they warn the public. So instead, I crossed that out and I put, should I, with the word I, meaning, you know, keep an eye out. Be smart. Be smart before you invest. And ultimately, you've got in here the undecided voter, too, because there's a lot of people who are still not sure. They're not quite sure about McCain. They're not sure about Obama. Basically, they're undecided voters. So that's what this piece here symbolizes. And you still do have the man in the middle, who is the quintessential undecided voter.